Okay, anyways, welcome to today's video. So this is, I actually lost count. I've only done a few, but I've lost count now. So this video, what have I done this morning? I've had breakfast, had coffee. I've picked up some wheels for the 86. These are wheels that are gonna be basically on the 86 when it goes to get the wide body fitted. So I had someone come over on Sunday to look at the wide body and kind of quote it up. So we're getting there. But yeah, plan is I'm gonna sell the CR Kais. If you know anyone interested in the CR Kais, because I obviously won't run them on the wide body, I will chuck them on Facebook and trade me and run these new 17-inch 5x100 wheels that I got off someone with a Subi. In the last video, I don't think I showed you guys a wide body kit, but I'll show you guys anyway. Sneak peek at the kit. I've only unwrapped like one back fender so far, but yeah, she's big. I think it worked out to be like 90 mils like wider on the side, so yeah, I've kind of got my fingers crossed that the wheels I did buy, which if you guys follow me on Instagram, are the new work CR2Bs. So I got them in a bit of an awkward size, but I'm gonna run spacers on them and hopefully push them out and fit the guards perfectly. But anyway, enough about the 86. Today's about the MX5. So I've got a new intake that I'm gonna fit, hopefully give a bit more induction noise, but hopefully improve the car's performance, because I do want to get the car tuned. I don't want to turbo this thing. It's more gonna be like the daily, like all the week, and thrash about. So Ivy is putting in her new indicators. She's doing it herself because she's a trained professional. I'll probably test it first before you put it back in. Wow.
So good.
All right, so a bit of an update for you guys. Don't mind the dogs barking in the background. So since last time you guys saw this, I've already done the exhaust before. Anyway, hey, keep the new stickers. Obviously got the skunk headers on there. Got the Battle Gang banner on there to match the 86. And the new splitter. The other one was all messed up on that side because I broke it over some speed bump. But anyway, that's a brand new one. I've cut it to size.
Hi.
Say hi, Ivy. Hey, doggos. This is Max, the neighbor.
Hi, Max.
Max.
Hey,
guys. Found something nice to stuff. You okay, Ivy? Okay team, check out the new headers. So shiny. Should probably wipe it down. First step is taking off the bumper. Okay, so I'm gonna start taking off this front bumper. MX5 bumpers, you've got to take off all these bolts on top, take up the under tray. You've got two sneaky hidden bolts here and like these trims. And you've got to take off the fly bolts. You're done. But check out these headers. So nice. Shout out to Skunk with these ones. I really want to paint the engine cover on this too one day. See if that all looking nice. I did take off the engine cover because it looked trash. Hopefully after today's install, clear up some more space here as well. So it's a big box. And looks like we've got a bit to unplug. But should be fine. Give you guys a wee update on Ivy's car as well. So obviously in the last video I told you guys we're getting some new wheels for it. Or I had some new wheels for it, so they're finally on. And we actually put on a new exhaust, or muffler delete, put on a big bore, and it sounds so much better now. But check out the car, it's actually sick. So these are the wheels. I had some center caps lying around and I decided to run those on them. Bit of dish. They aren't quite wide enough for the car, so I ended up putting 10mm spacers on. I'll probably need a bit more and a big bore exhaust. This without taking off the bash bar, but I have had to unbolt it from both sides to get this like plastic piece off. It's kind of like a water thing, but yeah, anyway, I don't know the name for it, but unbolted the bash bar. It's got to take off the airbox now, MAF sensor, or the airflow sensor, and just see mock up the new intake. Okay, so finally got the intake box off. I'm left with this mess. But feel the plastic. So about to mock up this new one. It's a good day for it, eh? Real windy, but warm. Anyway, about to mock it up, fit it, and I'll test it out and then start putting it back together. It should be easy from here, but the last time I didn't read instructions, things went terribly wrong, aka the sub from like the last video. So I might read the instructions this time, so I'm not confused with where everything goes. But yeah, do that. All right, so I finally got it on. This is what it looks like. Goes all the way up. MAF sensor's on. So much space here now. Kind of want to clean that. But I'll stop the music and let's see how it sounds. it's a bit of a spur of the moment. I am going to paint the dash bar. Gosh, it's so freaking windy. So I'm going to run the bumper without a grip. So you can explode. So the intake is exposed, but that means you can see the silver dash bar, which looks hideous, so I'm going to paint it black. Don't mind my hoary kind of like painting setup. It's outside, it's freaking windy, but I've got it done. So this is what I'm going to do. Okay, well, it's now black. Just a quick job. Doesn't actually look too bad, to be honest. I used... this stuff is amazing, but... metal cover. Matte black, no priming necessary, unpainted or pre-painted surfaces. Obviously, I prepped the bash bar real quick. Just a bit of mixing grease remover. And then paint it on top carefully. We'll kind of wait for the wind to drop and then go at it. So no, it looks pretty good. So obviously wait a few more minutes for the paint to dry. Take off my hoary masking. Don't do this at home. I feel like there's longer, better ways to do it. But hey, I'm in a bit of a rush, so if it works, it works. I'll put the bumper on and show you guys the final result. Okay, so bumper's on and actually looks pretty good. So obviously my riddle can job, let's tighten it up a bit, see the intake now. I don't know if you guys can even hear me, but yeah, looks all right. It's been like, I think it's been like 2 hours maybe. I was gonna say an hour and a bit, but I feel like it's been 2 hours, now like 30. The wind's starting to pick up. It's meant to be a crap week of rain. So I'm glad I'm doing it now, because next weekend's raining and I'm working, so. Yeah, intake, it's looking good. Bumper back on. Do I have any other parts to fit? Actually, I don't think I do. But yeah, sounds mint. You guys would have seen it in the sound clip. Time to wrap this all up. And I've got a few like little tiny bits to kind of put on the car. And then yeah, looks sick though. Looks sick. Tell me what you guys think. I mean, yeah, actually tell me what you guys think. Do I run the grill or do I leave it open like that? Because I kind of like it open. I did the same thing on the 86. So I painted like the bash bar, left it open so you can see the oil coolers all exposed. I kind of love the more exposed, aggressive look. But yeah, let me know what you guys think. I dig it personally, but everyone has their own opinions. So everything's all back together. It's a finished product. Not bad, it's coming along. Alright, so the phone died on me when I was finishing up the install, so here I am after the phone's charged. About to go take this thing for a test drive to make sure everything's all okay. That's going to be a real quick vlog slash install video, just to keep the YouTube videos up on the channel. A lot of feedback is record more mats. So we'll record, start recording mats. So what I'll do is, next time there's a mat, I will record, suck it up and just record basically, show you guys what actually goes on, for everyone interested. But yeah, that is it for the video. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace. Pull up in Canada, saw some crack to your mother in another